Good morning. Today we're going to look a little bit about the real numbers. The real numbers are, I made a diagram here. Let me put this apart of how we divide the real numbers. In your worksheet, you have a space to write the definition of real numbers. And in that definition, you should write real numbers are the set of numbers that include both irrational numbers and rational. So that's a definition of real numbers. And as you can see in this drawing, the real numbers are all the irrational and all the rational numbers. Now, what is irrational number and what is rational number? That's a good question. The irrational numbers are decimals that never end or do not repeat. So over here you have in your worksheet, there are some words that you need to write, are decimals that never end, that goes in your blank spaces, or have no repetition. And some examples, I have here some examples of irrational numbers. I'm sure that you have heard of pi number. It's a number that nobody has figured out because it's so long and it never repeats. We cannot express it. So we just write the letter, the symbol, pi. Now, rational numbers is the opposite. Are decimals that end, that goes in your blank space for the rationals, are decimals that end or they have a repeating, or they repeat. Have a repeating pattern. And some examples of rational numbers are this fraction, 5 seventh, number 3, the negative 1, 20 over 5, square root of 16, 0, etc. So if rationals never end, decimals that never end or repeat, rationals that do end or they repeat. Now we can divide rational numbers further. We can divide rationals into integers. Integers don't have decimal points. They are just a whole. But not only that, they also include negative numbers. For example, they include all the numbers. I'm going to try to write here 0, 1, 2, 3. And this goes to the infinite. So integers are all the whole numbers without decimal points, including the negatives. They are infinite. They start with a negative infinite, they go to the zero, and they start with a positive wholes. Those are called integers. Inside the integers, we have the whole numbers, which are similar to integers, except the whole numbers do not include negative numbers. So whole numbers start on zero. Zero is a whole number. 0, 1, 2, 3, and then goes to the infinite. And the last classification here is natural numbers. Natural numbers are similar to whole numbers, but they do not include 0. So natural numbers start with the positives, 1, 2, 3, etc. And that's how we divide the real numbers. Remember, the real numbers is the set of all numbers that include irrationals and rationals. Irrationals do not end, do not repeat. Rationals do end. Here are example polls for both. And you can fill out your worksheet with that. Another way to visualize real numbers is with the following graph. We can say that these are the real numbers. It's the set of all the irrationals. Let me write here, this will be the irrational numbers, and this should be the rational numbers. Within the rational numbers, we have the integers, and which are all the whole numbers and their negatives, including zero. Then we have the whole numbers, which do not include the negatives and start on zero. Right? And then we have the natural numbers, which don't include the zero and include only the whole numbers that are positive. From this graph, you can notice that all natural numbers are whole numbers as well. They are included. And all whole numbers are integers and all integers are rational. All of these are rationals and each one is included in the following circle. Now go ahead and work on your worksheet and I hope that you have some fun. Have a good day.